大家好，我是 Stella，
我是雨文。我们今天为您念的是《历史手册》第361课至365课。我愿献给你这神圣的一刻，请你为我做主。我一心追随你，并且坚信你的指引必会带给我平安。Lesson 361 to 365。This holy instant was a gift to you. Be you in charge, for I would follow you. Certain that your direction gives me peace. 让我们先来唱吧。
我愿献给你这神圣的一刻，请你为我做主，我一心追随你，并且坚信你的指引必会带给我平安。 This holy instant what I give to you, be you in charge, for I would follow you. Certain that your direction gives me peace. 我若需要片言之字，他必会提供协助。And if I need a word to help me, he will give it to me. 我若只需一念，他也会立即复运。If I need a thought, that will he also give. 我若需要一颗宁静而开放的心，他必会让我如愿。And if I need a stillness and a tranquil open mind, these are the gifts I will receive.of him. 他会应我之情而为我做主。 He is in charge by my request. 他不止聆听也会答复，因为他是上主，我的天父以及圣职的代言人。 And he will hear and answer me because he speaks of God, my Father, and his Holy Son.以下是这首的诗意。 You are blessed beings indeed. 你确实是有福之人。 I am that one that you know as Jesus. And the holy instant is where you hand over your mind to the Holy Spirit, to Christ consciousness, and to God. 我是你所知的 JC, 神圣一刻就是你将自己的心灵交托给圣灵，交托给基督意识，交托给上主。It is in the holy instant that you surrender your desires and say, Show me what you would have me do. Show me where you would have me go. Show me what you would have me say. Instead of planning everything by the ego's book, you stop and you ask for guidance. Ask for guidance whenever you have doubts or fears.你在神圣的一刻放下自己的渴望而说，请告诉我你要我做什么，请告诉我你要我前往何处，请告诉我你要做什么。你不依照小我的步骤来计划一切，而是停下来请求指引。每当你有疑问或恐惧时，你便请求指引。You must remember that your fears are your creations, and nobody, no matter how spiritually powerful they are, is permitted to remove from your experience what you have chosen to create. 你必须记得，你的恐惧是自己制造出来的。任何人，不论他的心灵力量多么强大，都不获准将你选择创造之物从你的经验中移除。 Your creations are your own, and so your fears are generated by you, nurtured by you, and respected by you. 你的创造物是你自己的，而你的恐惧乃是由你所造，由你所培育，接受到你的尊敬。 When you feel fear, Know that you have chosen incorrectly. Know that you are looking at the world incorrectly, and that you have left the eternal now, and you have gone into the future, and you are supposing about what might happen.
当你感到恐惧时，请了解你做了错误的选择，请了解你正用错误的眼光看世界。
When you feel fear, ask for guidance. Take a moment, sit down and say, I must have chosen incorrectly because I am afraid. I must have left this present moment because I am afraid.
且你已经离开了永恒的当下，你的心已经跑到了未来，你正在假定将来会发生什么事。当你感到恐惧时，请寻求指引，花点时间坐下来，并且说，我必定做了错误的选择，因为我感到害怕，我必定离开当下的一刻，因为我感到害怕。
How do I know I've left the present moment? Because nothing is happening here. Nothing bad is happening here. This is projection into the future of my own doing that be bringing my mind back here and ask for guidance.
我如何知道自己离开了当下一刻？因为此时此刻什么也没有发生。此时并没有坏事发生，我将自己的所作所为投射到了未来，让我将自己的信念带回当下，并请求指引。
And it may be that the guidance you get is very quiet. It may be that you don't really hear a voice, but you understand that if you stay in the present moment, come back from the future terror.That you have inflicted upon your own mind, you can at least sit in a room quietly for a moment and say, Nothing bad is happening. Show me what to do.
可能你所获得的指引是非常安静的，可能你没有真正听到声音，但是你了解，如果你专注在当下的一刻，你的心念从未来回到当下，跳出你强加自己心中的恐惧，那么你至少可以安静地坐在房间里片刻，并且说，此时没有坏事发生，请告诉我该怎么做。
You will always have an answer. It will come in the form of peace. It will come in the form of inspiration.
你总是会得到答复。它会以平安的形式出现，它会以灵感的形式出现。
It will come in some form. If you have trained your mind using the lessons of A Course in Miracles, and if you have practiced training your mind throughout the day, you will be able to pull your mind back into the present moment and calmly ask for guidance.
它会以某种形式出现。如果你已经运用奇迹课程来锻炼自己的心灵，如果你在一天当中实际锻炼你的心灵，你就有能力将你的信念带回到当下，并且平静地请求指引。
Now many people say they are not getting guidance, but you get guidance all the time through your feelings.
然而有很多人会说他们没有得到指引，事实上你一直透过你的感觉而获得指引。
If you have stepped back from fear, sat quietly down in your car, at your desk, or in your home and said, Please show me what to do. I do not know what to do in this situation. You will have a feeling of some kind.
如果你跳出恐惧，安静地坐在自己的车内、桌前或是家中，并且说，请告诉我该怎么做，我不知道在这个情况下该怎么做，你会获得某种感觉。
It may be just a feeling to stop moving and not do anything that is guidance.
可能你会有一种感觉要你不要动，且什么都不要做，那就是指引。Many of you are seeking guidance in the forms of words, of direct instruction from a voice in your head. Well, you are getting direct instruction. It is through that impeccable guidance system that you have your feelings.很多人所寻求的指引形式是听到脑海中直接的言语指示，事实上你确实透过你的感觉这个万无一失的导向系统而获得直接的指引。 It may be that you get a feeling to go out and get some fresh air and go for a walk. It may be that you get a feeling to take a napIt may be that you get a feeling to phone a friend and ask for help. This is spiritual guidance. 你可能会得到一种感觉，要你去呼吸一些新鲜空气，或是去散散步。你可能会得到一种感觉，要你小憩一下。你可能会得到一种感觉，要你打电话给朋友并请求帮助。这就是灵性的指引了。If it is a loving act, if it is a calming act, if it is a peace-inducing act, it is coming from spirit. 如果那是充满爱的作为，如果那是平静的作为，如果那是能够带来平安的作为，那就是来自圣灵的指引。If it is a fear-inducing act, if it is an agitated feeling,If it is a scared feeling, it is coming from the ego. 如果那是引发恐惧的作为，如果那是一种焦虑的感觉，如果那是恐惧的感觉，那就是来自小我。The ego feels different than spirit, and it is going to be a learning process for all of you to discern the difference between the ego's fearful guidance and spirit's gentleLoving and calm guidance. 小我带给你的感觉跟圣灵带给你的感觉是不同的。对你们大家来说，这将是一个学习的过程，学会分辨小我令人恐惧的指引以及圣灵温柔、慈爱及平静的指引之间的差别。 And as you go through the next few years practicing what you have learnedWith these lessons, you are going to get better and better and better at it. 只要你在接下来的几年持续练习，你从这些课程练习中所学到的观念，那么你的分辨能力就会变得越来越好，越来越好。I'm that one that you know as Jesus, and I will speak to you again tomorrow. 我是你所知的 JC, 我们明天再续。
让我们再来唱一次吧。
我愿献给你这深深的一刻，请你为我做主，我一心追随你，并且坚信你的指引必会带给我平安。 This holy instant word I give to you, be you in charge, for I would follow you, certain that your direction gives me peace.
这历史手册第361课至365课，我愿献给你这神圣的一刻，请你为我做主，我一心追随你，并且坚信你的指引必会带给我平安。 Lesson 361 to 365. This holy instant was I give to you, be you in charge, for I would follow youCertain that your direction gives me peace. 奇迹中文记31章最终的会见 Chapter 31 The Final Vision 2与基督同行 Two, working with Christ.
人类最古老的课题不是你不断太旧换新就解决得了的。An ancient lesson is not overcome by the opposing of the new and old. 你不需要达到它才可能知道真相，你也无需大事抨击才能赢得真理的芳心。It is not vanished that the truth be known, nor fought against to lose to truth's appeal. 新的人生课题无需战争为它铺路，它既不靠你投入的时间，更不靠你计划如何周全。There is no battle that must be prepared, no time to be expended, and no plans that need be laid for bringing in the new. 自古以来，达到真理的战争始终层出不穷，真理一概相应不离。There is an ancient battle being waged against the truth, but truth does not respond.这种战争除了伤他自己以外又伤害得了谁？ Who could be hurt in such a war unless he hurts himself? 在真理内他其实没有敌人， He has no enemy in truth. 梦境岂能侵犯得了他？ And can he be assailed by dreams?我们不妨再温习一回，你和自己的真相之间究竟还有什么东西居中作梗。Let us review again what seems to stand between you and the truth of what you are. 我们才好按部就班清除那些障碍。For there are steps in its relinquishment. 第一步是决定，这必须由你来做。The first is a decision that you make. 随之而来的真相则属天赐的恩典。But afterwards, the truth is given you. 然而你却试图制定真相。You would establish truth. 这个妄想为你造出了两种选择，从此凡事你都不能不选择了。And by your wish, you set two choices to be made each time you think you must decide on anything. 然而这两种选择都不是真的， neither is true. 他们才毫无不同， nor are they different. 我们必须同时看见两者，才能越过他们而看到另一种截然不同的选项。 Yet must we see them both?Before you can look past them to the one alternative that is a different choice. 你在梦中找不出这个选项，但却能使它隐晦不明。But not in dreams you made, that this might be obscured to you. 你自己设定的两种选择称不上是选择，最多只给你一种自由的幻觉，因为不论你选择哪一个，结果都是一样的。What you would choose between is not a choice and gives, but the illusion it is free, for it will have one outcome either way. 因此不能算是选择。Thus, is it really not a choice at all? 在这选择下，冒出领导者与追随者两种不同的角色，两者似乎都具有令你难以割舍的价值。The leader...And the follower emerge as separate roles, each seeming to possess advantages you would not want to lose. 两种角色加在一起好似给你满足及平安的双重希望。So in their fusion, there appears to be the hope of satisfaction and of peace.从此你在自己的眼中分裂成两种角色，且还永远对立。 You see yourself divided into both these roles, forever split between the two. 你把每个朋友或每个敌人都变成让你逃避这种分裂或对立的工具。And every friend or enemy becomes a means to help you save yourself from this. 你也许会把那个关系称之为爱。Perhaps you call it love. 有时你又会把它当成他罪该万死的理由。Perhaps you think that it is murder justified at last.当你自己想当领袖时，你会痛恨被你推为领袖的人，但当你不愿意领导而退为随从，你又恨他为善尽领导之责。You hate the one you gave the leader's role when you would have it, and you hate as well his not assuming it at times. You want to let the follower.In you arise and give away the role of leadership. 这就是你找出弟兄的目的，你也慢慢学会把这当成他存在的目的。And this is what you made your brother for, and learned to think that this his purpose is. 除非他能发挥这一作用，否则表示他为恪尽你赋予他之责。Unless he serves it.He has not fulfilled the function that was given him by you. 因此他罪该万死，对你而言他已失去存在的目的，故也毫无利用的价值了。 And thus he merits death, because he has no purpose and no usefulness to you. 至于他呢？ And what of him? 他又想从你这儿得到什么？What does he want of you? 他所要的不也是你想从他那儿得到的东西吗？ What could he want but what you want of him? 再次，选择生命或选择死亡，只在一念之间，不论你选什么，都是为他而选的。Herein is life as easily as death. For what you choose as well for him.你向他发出两种呼求，你对他也是如此。Two calls you make to him as he to you. 这两者才是你真正的选项，因为他们会带来不同的后果。Between these two is choice, because from them there is a different outcome. 你若选择死亡，不论是他带领你或你带领他，都毫无区别。If he be the leader or the follower to you, it matters not, for you have chosen death. 但你是在呼求死亡还是生命，呼求仇恨还是宽恕与援助，却能为你带来截然不同的结果。But if he calls for death or calls for life, for hate or for forgiveness and for help, it's not the same in outcome.你听到的若是前者，就会与他分裂而迷失自己。Hear the one and you are separate from him and are lost. 你若听到了后者，就会与他结合，且在自己的答复中获得救恩。But hear the other and you enjoy with him, and in your answer is salvation found.你在他那里说听到的其实是你自己的心声。The voice you hear in him is but your own. 他究竟在向你要求什么？ What does he ask you for? 仔细聆听吧。And listen well. 不论他要求什么都会降临于你，因为你会在其中看到自己的形象，听见自己的心声。For he is asking what will come to you because you see an image of yourself and hear your voice requesting what you want. 在你答复以前，不妨暂停片刻，想一想这句话。Before you answer, pause to think of this. 我如何答复弟兄，表示我正在祈求什么。The answer that I give my brother.Is what I am asking for. 我在他身上学到什么，表示我会在自己身上看到什么。And what I learn of him is what I learn about myself. 然后静静等候一会儿，忘记过去你自以为听到的一切，随时提醒自己所知何其有限。Then let us wait an instant and be still, forgetting everything we thought we heard, remembering how much we do not know. 这位弟兄既不在前领导，也不在后追随，他伴随着我们，走在同一条路上。This brother neither leads nor follows us, but walks beside us on the self-same road.他和我们一模一样，我们让他距离多近或多远，他们就会离我们多近或多远。He is like us, as near or far away from what we want as we will let him be. 他若不能与我们一起受惠，我们也会空手而回。他若没有进步，我们就会退步。We make no gains he does not make with us, and we fall back if he does not advance. 为此，你应满怀爱心，而非怒气冲冲地牵起他的手。你的进步全仰赖他的进步。Take not his hand in anger, but in love, for in his progress do you count your own. 除非你把他安全地护守在身边，否则我们就会成为陌路。And we go separately along the way, unless you keep him safely by your side.
在上主的爱内，他与你完全一样，你才可能不受他的外形蒙蔽而答复基督的呼唤。
Because he is your equal in God's love, you will be saved from all appearances and answer to the Christ who calls to you.
静下心来，好好的聆听吧。Be still and listen. 别再留恋那远古的妄念了。
Think not ancient thought.
放下过去所有与他不愉快的经验，听，上主之子正在召唤你呢。
Forget the dismal lessons that you learned about the Son of God who calls to you.
基督以同等温柔的爱召唤着所有的人，他眼中没有领导或随从之分，他只会听到上主赐给所有人的统一答复。
Christ.Calls to all with equal tenderness, seeing no leaders and no followers, and hearing but one answer to them all.
因为他只聆听一个天音，故也只能听到一个答复，也就是他受命为上主唯一圣旨时所给的唯一答复，他不可能听到别的答复的。
Because he hears one voice, he cannot hear a different answer from the one he gave when God appointed him his only son.
让自己安静片刻吧。Be very still an instant. 忘却过去学来的一切想法，放下自己营造的所有形象。来吧。
Come without a thought of what you ever learned before, and put aside all images you made.
旧有的一切只会让位给新的，无需你去推翻或拥护。
The old will fall away before the new without your opposition or intent.
没有人会抨击你心中依旧珍惜的宝贝。
There will be no attack upon the things you thought were precious and in need of care.
也没有人抨击你对那根本不存在的呼唤之向导。
There will be no assault upon your wish to hear a call that never has been made.
在此圣地无一物伤害得了你，因此你能够静心下来聆听，学习看出什么才是你真正想要之物。
Nothing will hurt you in this holy place to which you come to listen silently and learn the truth of what you really want.
上天只要求你学会这一本事。
No one than this will you be asked to learn. 当你听到这一要求，便会明白你只需放下自己根本不想要也毫不真实的念头，便能来到这一圣地。 But as you hear it, you will understand you need but come away without the thought you did not want and that were never true.
宽恕弟兄所有的表象吧，他们不过代表了你不断提醒自己罪孽深重的那一股老课题。
Forgive your brother all appearances that are but ancient lessons you have taught yourself about the sinfulness in you.
你可听见他正在求你慈悲相待，请你帮他由他对自己以及对你所怀的可怕形象中释放出来。
Hear but his call for mercy and release from all the fear images he holds of what he is and of what you must be.
他害怕与你并肩同行，认为落后半步或超前一点会比较安全。
He is afraid to walk with you and thinks perhaps a bit behind, a bit ahead would be a safer place for him to be.
你若怀有同样想法，认为他落后一步，你才会超前，或他一超前，你就落后，你怎么可能进步？
Can you make progress if you think the same? Advancing only when he would step back and falling back when he would go ahead.
这表示你忘了这旅程的目的，你原本决心与他并肩同行的，既无意义在前领导，也不想尾随其后。
For so do you forget the journey's goal, which is but to decide to walk with him, so neither leads nor follows.
你们只愿一起前进，而非踽踽独行。
Thus it is a way you go together, not alone.
只有这一选择才能扭转你此生的学习结果，因基督已在你们内重生了。
And in this choice is learning's outcome changed, for Christ has been reborn to both of you.
只要你放下旧有的观念片刻，诸如你那伟大的道友是何许人也，以及他可能对你有何要求，你就不难获得上述的经验。
An instant spent without your old ideas of who your great companion is and what he should be asking for will be enough to let this happen.
你必会看出他的目的与你全然一致，
and you will perceive his purpose is the same as yours.
他要的正是你想要的，他之所需也是你之所需。
He asks for what you want and needs the same as you.
即使他提出的要求形式与你不同，然而你的答复也不再受制于那些形式了。
It takes perhaps a different form in him, but it is not the form you answer to.
他要求你接受如此而已。因你们原是为了这一目的来到人间的，学习以手足之爱对待自己的弟兄。
He asks, and you receive, for you have come with but one purpose, that you learn you love your brother with a brother's love.
他既是你的弟兄，他的天赋必是你的天赋，他的真相必然与你的真相一致。
And as a brother, must his father be the same as yours, as he is like yourself in truth.
你们一吸收并进，两人都会一起并领受你们共同承继的产业。
Together is your joint inheritance remembered and accepted by you both.
若凭自己，谁都得不到这份产业。
Alone it is denied to both of you.
你若坚持充当领导或随从的角色，显然表示你认为自己独自走在路上，无人伴你同行。
Is it not clear that while you still insist on leading or on following, you think you walk along with no one by your side?
这种人生道路必然不知所踪，因光明无法照耀。踽踽独行的人，你也看不清自己何去何从。
何从。This is the road to nowhere, for the light cannot be given while you walk along, and so you cannot see which way you go.
你就这样迷失了，步履蹒跚，孤独的往返或颠扑于黑暗中，深受自我怀疑之苦。
And thus there is confusion and a sense of endless doubting as you stagger back and forward in the darkness and alone.
幸好这种旅途以及那种走法只是表面看来如此。
Yet these are but appearances of what the journey is and how it must be made.
你始终有一位圣者在前为你高举明灯，让你们一步走得安稳，对自己的道路充满信心。
For next to you is one who holds the light before you, so that every step is made in certainty and sureness of the road.
你若蒙上自己的眼睛，最多只会遮住你的视线，却无法把道路变得黑暗。
A blindfold can indeed obscure your sight, but cannot make the way itself grow dark.
与你同行的那一位始终充满了光明，
and he who travels with you as the light.
三，自我谴责。Three, the self-accused.
自我谴责人必会定他人的罪， only the self-accused condemn.你若准备选择另一结局，就必须先熟悉这新的本事。
As you prepare to make a choice that will result in different outcomes, there is first one thing that must be overlearned.
它必须成为你的惯性，打破你的典型作风。不论面临什么诱惑或处于何种境遇，你都能不假思索地作此反应。
It must become a habit of response so typical of everything you do that it becomes your first response to all temptation and to every situation that occurs.
好好的学吧，它会加速幸福的来临，为你省下难以估计的时间。
Learn this and learn it well, for it is here delay of happiness is shortened by a span of time you cannot realize.
你对弟兄所怀的怨恨，绝不是针对他的罪，而是你自己的罪。
You never hate your brother for his sins, but only for your own.
不论他的罪以什么形式呈现，只是为了遮掩一个事实，就是你心知肚明的，其实都是你自己的罪过，因此理当迎头痛击。
Whatever form his sins appear to take, it but obscures the fact that you believe them to be yours, and therefore meriting a just attack.
若非你相信自己的罪是不可宽恕的，否则他那些罪怎么会成为一种罪？
Why should his sins be sins if you did not believe they could not be forgiven in you?
若非你相信那些罪真的在你内，否则他的罪怎么会显得如此真实？
Why are they real in him if you did not believe that they are your reality?
若非你如此痛恨自己，否则你岂会对他的罪这般收下不留情？
And why do you attack them everywhere except you hate yourself?
你是一个罪吗？ Are you a sin?你一发动攻击就等于默认了，因着你的攻击证明了自己有罪，才会把自己应得的报应加在别人身上。
You answer yes whenever you attack, for by attack do you assert that you are guilty and must give as you deserved.
然而什么才是你分内应得之物，不就是你的真相吗？
And what can you deserve but what you are?
你若不相信自己会受到攻击，真会想到去攻击别人。
If you did not believe that you deserved attack, it never would occur to you to give attack to anyone at all.
你何苦如此？
Why should you?
这对你有何益处？
What would be the gain to you?
那其实你想要的结局？
What could the outcome be that you would want?
谋害别人真会带给你任何益处 ？And how could murder bring you benefit？ 罪只可能存在身体内。Sins are in bodies。你不可能在心灵里看到罪的。They are not perceived in minds。罪属于行为层次，而非目的层次。They are not seen as purposes, but actions. 身体负责行动，而心灵是不行动的。Bodies act and minds do not. 为此，只有身体需要为他所做的一切负责。And therefore, must the body be at fault for what it does? 身体在你眼中绝非只会服从指令，而且一无所能的机器而已。It is not seen to be a passive thing, obeying your commands, and doing nothing of itself at all. 你若是罪，表示你是一具身体，因心灵不是行为的主体。If you are sin, you are a body, for the mind acts not. 于是生存的目的便若在身体，而非心灵了。And purpose must be in the body, not the mind.身体成了一个自主且自动的生命。The body must act on its own and motivate itself. 你若是罪，表示你已把心灵锁在身体内，且把心灵的存在目的转交给囚禁它的牢狱，任由身体代它做主。If you are sin, you lock the mind within the body, and you give its purpose to its prison house, which acts instead of it. 狱卒原本不必服从命令的，他是向囚犯下指令的人。A jailer does not follow orders, but enforces orders on the prisoner. 身体才是囚犯，而非心灵。Yet is the body prisoner and not the mind. 身体是生不出任何念头的。The body thinks no thoughts. 它没有学习宽恕或奴役他人的能力。It has no power to learn, to pardon, nor enslave. 心灵无需遵守身体的指示，也不必服从身体的规范。It gives no orders that the mind need serve, nor sets conditions that it must obey. 身体只囚禁得了自愿被囚的心灵。It holds in prison but the willing mind that would abide in it. 当心灵自甘沦为身体的阶下囚时，身体才会离病。It sickens at the bidding of the mind that would beCome it prisoner. 他开始衰老死亡，因为心灵已经病了。And it grows old and dies because that mind is sick within itself. 若要挽回这一局势，你必须重新学习。Learning is all that causes change. 身体没有学习能力，故它永无改变的可能。直到心灵赋予身体另一目的，身体才会跟随心灵的指令而改变自己的外形。And so the body where no learning can occur could never change unless the mind preferred the body change in its appearances to suit the purpose given by the mind. 只有心灵具有学习的能力，因此任何改变必然出自心灵。 For mind can learn and there is all change made. 视自己为罪之化身的心灵只有一个目的，就是让身体成为罪的元凶。心灵会把身体关在自己为他宣定并坚守的牢狱里，害得自己也不得脱身。于是心灵便与昏睡的囚犯一样，受尽怨恨、邪恶、疾病、受害、衰老、哀伤与痛苦这类恶犬的折磨。 The mind that thinks it is a sin has but one purpose, that the body be the source of sin. To keep it in the prison house, it chews and guards and holds itself at bay a sleeping prisoner to the snarling dogs, or hate and evil, sickness and attack of pain and age, of grief and suffering.
牺牲之念就是由此酝酿出来的，醉酒在此成王，且把世界搞得像智深一样冷酷无情，除了谋害及死亡，无人幸免于恐惧的摧残。
Here are the thoughts of sacrifice preserved, for here guilt rules, and orders that the world be like itself, a place where nothing can find mercy, nor survive the revenges of fear, except in murder and in death.
你就是如此照出了罪的，他无法活在喜悦与自由之境，因两者都是罪，除之而后快的心腹大患。
For here are you made sin, and sin cannot abide the joyous and the free, for they are enemies which sin must kill.
只有死亡才是罪的有力护持，凡是认为自己就是罪的人，不能不为此信念付出死亡的代价。
In death is sin preserved, and those who think that they are sin must die for what they think they are.
你相信什么就会看到什么，但你随时都能改变自己的信念，我们该为此而庆幸。
Let us be glad that you will see what you believe, and that it has been given you to change what you believe.
身体对你唯命是从，
The body will but follow.
它绝对无法把你带到你不愿前往的地方。
It can never lead you where you would not be.
它保护不了你的梦境，但也阻挠不了你的觉醒。
It does not guard your sleep, nor interfere with your awakening.
将你的身体由牢狱释放吧，你一旦由牢狱脱身，便不会把任何人视为囚犯了。
Release your body from imprisonment, and you will see no one as prisoner to what you have escaped.
你不会把自己认定的仇敌关在醉酒之内，更不会把你心目中的朋友锁在无常且虚幻的爱里。
You will not want to hold in guilt your chosen enemies, nor keep in chains to the illusion of a changing love the ones you think are friends.
纯洁无罪的人会感恩于自己解脱而释放别人。
The innocent release in gratitude for their release.
他们的说知说见都会维护自己的自由，使他们不受束缚于死亡之害。
And what they see upholds their freedom from imprisonment and death.
打开你的心灵，接受改变吧。之后，不论是你或你的弟兄，都不再受千古业报所苦了。
Open your mind to change, and there will be no ancient penalty exacted from your brother or yourself.
因上主说过，他从不要求牺牲，故也无人能够牺牲。
For God has said, there is no sacrifice that can be asked. There is no sacrifice that can be made.
启示中文第31章最终的会见 Chapter 31 The Final Vision 二与基督同行2. Working with Christ 3. 自我谴责 3. The self-accused
愿大家有一个生命充满的一天阿们，我爱你哦